Here we're going to have a look at adding the glow effect to a light, and then we'll have a go at applying it to an object too, so that the object looks like it's glowing. So, first thing we need to do is add a light. So in lights, we go to standard, and we'll just use a basic Omni light. We'll add that to our scene. Again, I'm not going to set any of the attenuation or so on. You can choose to do that at another time. In rendering, come down to effects, and you'll see the environment and effects dialog box. Click on add, select lens effect, and then lower down, select glow, click on the button to bring it to the other side, and then click on pick light and select our light, and we need to click on render to see this, and there's our glow added to the light. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up in the dialog box and select interactive. Now any changes that we make now will automatically be updated in the render. So for instance, if I change the intensity, you can see that's being automatically updated. If I reduce the size or increase the size, you can see the effect that this is having. So that's how you add it to a light, nice and easy. Now I want to add it to an object. So let's create a teapot. I need to turn off the interactive for now. Let's create a teapot. And you right click on the teapot, select object properties, and you're looking for GBuffer, object ID, and I'm going to change that to 1. And that'd be a unique number for each object that you want to apply a different glow to. So if I OK that, and then in the scene, I come down to the glow element, click on options, and check object ID. And you can see it's already set to 1 because that's the first object that we have. Let's have a look and render this. Whoa. So the glow is quite unrealistic. I've noticed in 2012 version of Max that the glow doesn't quite work the same in the new software, so we'll have a go at tweaking this quickly. So in parameters, we'll come down, we'll reduce the size. Let's check interactive again. So for lens effect globals, we're reducing the size just down a little bit. Put it down to 5, and then we'll reduce the size for our glow elements. There's the glow happening there. Reduce the intensity slightly so you can see the glow. Okay, so I have to play around, change some of the settings, see what sort of effects you can come up with.